On this prestigious occasion, I take the privilege to extend a very warm welcome to all our distinguished guests. We have with us Mr. Munindar Anand, Managing Director, India and Asia Center for Creative Leadership, also known as CCL. Mr. Anand has more than 20 years of experience with professional services firms and the industry and has held P&L responsibilities for several leading firms in South Asia. As a Managing Director for CCL India and South Asia, Mr. Anand's core responsibilities include drawing out of strategy, managing clients, people and processes for the success of CCL in these regions. Mr. Anand brings a diverse range of capabilities in the domains of talent development, HR transformation, change management, organizational design, post-merger integration, institutional capacity building, and strengthening. Mr. Anand is well connected with the region's HR and professional services industries, having served as Joint Secretary for the Delhi and NCR chapter of India's National HR Development Network, also known as NHRDN, and as a member of NHRDN's Young Minds Council for Emerging Professionals. We welcome you to the occasion, sir. Vice President of Finance and Strategy, Company Secretary and Corporate Strategies, currently with LT Group Companies, commonly known as Dawat Rides. She is an experienced company secretary with a demonstrated history of working in the food and beverage industry, strong business development professional, skilled in FMCG, management, corporate finance, due diligence, and mergers and acquisition. We welcome you to the occasion, ma'am. Thank you.
Good morning, everybody. With all due respect to the eminent people on the dais, Mr. Munindar Anand, Mr. Shubhankar Ghosh, Ms. Monica Sinjadia, Squadron Leader in Kulnayak, Mr. Sandeep Marwa, Mr. Saurabh Sharma, and Mr. Gurdeep Singh Raina. I, on behalf of entire Asian Education Group, take that privilege of welcoming you all to the inaugural function of the orientation program of BBA program of 2017. The day when I talk about is very auspicious for us, as this is the academic event that we take it in Asian Education Group, where the entire set of fraternity at Asian Education Group is eager to take the responsibility of the students, the fresh students coming to develop their future with us, and that, believe me, that responsibility is huge. But over a period of time, year after the years that we have worked upon the professional development of the students and have been, I'm proud to say, have been successful enough in developing their future and the career graph for the better livelihoods. So when it comes to that responsibility, we take at Asian Education Group, each and every member owns each and every student and then try to pay the individual attention and a development plan for the people, so that each and every individual out here, when he moves out after the processing of the 3 years, is a different individual. We make sure that the two individuals in the class are able to identify their abilities as a concept that I understand each one of us is equally able and are born with equal abilities. But then, over a period of time, how do we realize that what are the abilities that can be developed and how it can be developed? And that process is professionalism, where we try to develop our abilities to capabilities and then capabilities to the competence. And that is how the level of competence that comes over a period of time when we actually apply the knowledge that we have or we try to gather in our schools, then in our professional course, and then apply it time again to develop that skill set, okay, that is in practice and that is in the subconscious mind. But then, yes, practicing it time again, you develop capabilities, and then capabilities, you need to sharpen it further with the expertise to have that competence level. So that is the journey. That is the journey where the institution plays its vital role and understands the roles and responsibilities of each one of us, that how do we go about it. But the major core part that comes is with you. Because whatever good plan that I have to develop, the individual student, I'll not be able to do as an institution if you are not responsible for your own self. So from my end, from the institution's point of view, the professional journey is, you know, about the capabilities and the competence that I was talking. But how do we get it is the individual responsibility. So when I talk about responsibility, it is all about owning your own self. So far, fortunately and unfortunately, the kind of academic system, the kind of upbringing in the families that we have, we are more dependent upon, you know, the parents, the teachers, the friends, the surroundings. But very rarely that we think about being independent. So the journey which you are starting today is about independence. You need to be independent, independent for your own self, own your own needs. Yes, if I have got less marks, I have got because I did not study. Normally what we say, the paper was tough, the teacher did not do the correct checking or X, Y, Z reasons. But then you need to own, because who am I, only I know. Nobody else. Not even my best of the friend, not even my parents, not even my best of the teachers. So the struggle, or I'll not say the struggle, yes, a struggle for the independence is to win over your own self. So far, we have not done the introspections for ourselves, what we are made for, or what we intend to do. So this, and believe me, right from today, if you start introspecting your own self, know your own self, yes, all positives, negatives together, but then introspect and see what abilities that I have. What can I build up upon? And believe me, each one of us has got a unique coefficient that I talk about that makes me different from others. The only thing is that I don't know it and I don't work on it. Right? So, we at the Asian Education Group have got the processes in place where we'll help you introspect who you are and then give you a mirror that this is how you look like. And then you sit with it and then, you know, we develop the individual development plans which would be unique for you. But again, the focus that I'm time again talking about is the ownership. Until unless you own your own self, you have that desire to, you know, get yourself processed through for the professional development, it would not come. And believe me, you can do it from any other place. If you don't do the professional course the way the professional courses are supposed to be, it is of no use. So we have got that mindset and the thought process where we talk about, even after BBA, I know majority of the people who think of doing some PG course or some, you know, further studies or, you know, have some their own business and all. But I talk about that if after 3 years' time you are not able to fetch a job for yourself in the corporate market, then you have not done it for yourself. Whether you do that job or don't do that job is absolutely your choice. But then have that onus, have that honor that yes, I could give the interview, say for 30-35,000 rupees a job, and then I was able to fetch it for myself. That feeling would give you that proud and give you that feeling of independence that yes, after doing this course, I am independent for my livelihood. I have developed myself for that livelihood. Now onwards, whatever that come, at least I know my worth. I can earn that much amount of the money and live my livelihood, be the support for my own self, my surroundings, my parents, my family, my friends. And from there, probably, that journey of success, that starts. So even if you do your further studies, but you have that confidence in yourself at any given time that I am capable of pitching a job for this job, this salary. Meaning, at any given time, that I can create a space for myself in the corporate world and prove my own worth. And from there, any and every step that I take, it would be towards the success of my career path or my livelihood. So, time again, the question is, who am I, right? And how do I develop myself? How do I assist my teachers to help me grow and develop further? Because the teachers, the mentors are there in place to help you out, but then it is you who need to time again go and talk about that I am so and so, and then I need your assistance to help me improve in this trait, in this skill, in this knowledge, and then have the best possible path for yourself, for your growth and independence. With all that, I welcome you again to Asian Education Group for your professional course, and wish you all the very success and a very good stay in Asian Education Group, and see you all as the shining star in the near future to come. All the very best. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. First of all, I would like to give a very warm welcome to all the dignitaries present on the dais today. I will also congratulate all the students and the parents who are starting a new journey today. A new phase, the graduation years. The first phase, the schooling phase, is over. It's a middle layer before your post-graduation, after your schooling, and it's equally important as well. I would say that there are certain things which are very easy to understand or comprehend by all of you, which could be that it's not only just about the hard work which you have to put in the next 3 years, but also maintaining a balance in terms of your extracurriculars, your communication skills, and your brains as well. I won't throw much light upon that, but one thing which I felt, like an incident which I, like my friend happened to share with me, I would say a few months back, I felt like sharing it with you as well. So what he narrated me was that he was there with his family and he went to a zoo. And he happened to cross a path where there were some elephants which were tied to a rope. And they were huge, obviously those bigger ones. And the rope was very small and just tied to a tree. So he was pretty inquisitive because he was not enjoying being in the zoo. And his kids and wife probably were more keen for that. So he went to the trainer and asked a thing that, okay, how do the elephants, or how do you hold these elephants with just this small rope, which if they try to break, they can break it very easily. It's not a chain, it's not a cage, just simple rope. So what the trainer said was something which probably he learned from, or I also pondered after that, and probably you can also think about. He said that these elephants, when they're young, they are tied to the same rope, same size, same thickness, same everything. So over the years, when they grow up, they develop a mindset which is that they cannot break this rope. When they were young, they didn't have the power to break that rope. But as and when they grow older, psychologically, they develop those inhibitions in their mind that they still can't break it and they don't go anywhere. So if we apply that thing to our own self, what we realize is that we also have been brought up with some inhibitions. Since the time we were brought into this world, we were youngsters, we saw something. Like if in your case, or probably a few years back, or 10 years back, a decade back, in my case, there could be inhibitions that, if I want to publicly relate it to you, that okay, I've been scoring on an average basis in my schooling, probably 60 percentilers, 70 percentile, I can never crack into the 80-90 league. That is that same rope or that inhibition which you are tying yourself with. Two, we are being brought up with the thought that, okay, if you don't have funds, if you're not from a business family, you cannot be a businessman. You probably will have to work in a corporate or a company and then only make your way ahead. That is again a rope, that's again an inhibition, because we have examples like Mark Zuckerberg or Ivan Spill who have done wonders at a very young age. So it's not necessary to be having any of those things with you which you don't have to become something which you want to be. And there are several of those. So the thing which I imbibed out of this particular interaction of mine with that friend was that it's all in the mind. You're all but a person of your own choices. It is your choices what make you, nothing else. We can also learn a lot from nature as well. For example, even a tree, I would say, it teaches you how to stay grounded. Even whatever you become in the future, the one important thing for you is to always stay grounded and stable in your head. And you're young, probably you'll understand it over the years, but that's a very important thing to be done. Second is to stay connected with your roots. Your parents are here, most of them, and are happy to see you this way. You have to reciprocate that as well. That's also very, very important for you. So being in touch with them when they reach that older age, staying grounded, connected to your roots, your family, your elders, is something which will give you more prosperity in the future. Third thing I would say is, which again is a learning, is that it's okay to adjust and bend a bit when there's a storm. The trees which stand straight are the ones which fell first. And the trees which bend a bit are the ones which fall first. So the point is that when there is an adverse situation which you face or might face in the future, I'm not saying succumb to it or go down to it completely, but making certain adjustments would only be fruitful for you. Okay? And you should be growing as well. Keeps going. The only thing which I would say, though I never thought of it, I just realized you should not stay stagnant at a place. That is the only thing which probably you cannot or may not try to imbibe from that particular thing. So it's also very important to, I would say, have a direction or the clarity of direction. Why? Because some people I feel are going too fast but without any direction. That would lead them to nowhere. So having clarity at this stage, though it's early, you're 17, 18 year old, all individuals sitting over here. But you should also try to start thinking, if somebody has thought that's really good, but you should try to start thinking that, okay, what is it leading up to for me? How do I want to place my life? What after this? How do I see myself doing something? Because what you think is mostly what happens to you as well. One more thing which you can actually utilize over here is that you've not been properly at a school level as well, in your class or something. Be interacting with so many people, I would say your seniors who will be there with you, the PGD members, students over here, the law students over here, your faculty members, your corporate society members, your fellow classmates as well. Interaction is really important. If you keep speaking, that's why people say you should be a good listener. Why? Because if you keep speaking, you just repeat the thing which you already know. But if you listen, then you actually can know something which you probably don't know. Very important to interact with everybody, and that is what would be one of the reasons for you to probably be successful after this course or after your post graduation or something. Lastly, I would say that it's okay to be inspired by somebody's journey. It's okay to be, you can say, feeling happy about knowing somebody's success, but don't exactly follow somebody or aim somebody. Okay, because you are all individuals, you have your own lives till now. Own identity and try to make it your own only. Don't try to ape somebody or just blindly follow anyone. The only time probably when you can think of following what somebody has left it, when probably you are left in the forest all alone and lost. So if you see a path, then definitely follow it, okay? So I would say that I welcome you again on behalf of Asian Education Group Asian School of Business. It's probably not necessary to say, but I would say that we'll ensure